First of all, I'd like to clarify a point. Earlier on tonight, you made a statement involving incarnation, involving a comparison of Christianity with Hinduism. Well, to clarify a point, we do not believe that the purpose of Jesus Christ coming down in the form of man was for the simple reason of understanding man's problems, but instead to take on the sin of the world. And because of that, there is no real parallel between an incarnation of comparing Hinduism faith with the faith of Christianity. And second, the point that I'd really like to address your entire issue tonight is that it seemed to me that it was more not necessarily who is Christ and what is his purpose, but it was more like an attack upon men, Christian men, your men. I mean, I appreciate Muhammad and I appreciate all the great prophets, but it's God that is above all of us. And, you know, we really have no right to compare ourselves on the same standpoint. And so to bring in man versus man is really irrelevant when it comes to God and Christianity and the Muslim faith. And so I'd like to know not necessarily what you believe on the attack of a Jimmy Swaggart or a Pat Robertson or your own people, but instead I'd like to know where is it you stand on Jesus Christ in comparison to God and your Muslim faith, in the comparison between faith, not men.
I thought I made it abundantly clear with regards to what we accept Jesus to be. I said, and I repeat, that Jesus Christ, we believe, was one of the mightiest messengers of God. I said, we believe in his miraculous birth, which many modern day Christians don't believe today. We believe in his many miracles, including those of giving life to the dead by God's permission and of healing those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. Then I said, there is a parting of the ways. And that is, you say that he's God, we say he's not God. You say he's God incarnate, we say God does not incarnate. Is that an attack? Or is this putting forth to you our position, saying, look, this is our position, instead of hypocritically telling you, you know, he performed many miracles and what he did and he spoke as a child and all that, and says, now I scratch your back and you scratch my back. Was that what I was trying to do? I said, look, we accept all these things, we are going together, here is the parting of the ways. We say, he's not God, and he's not God incarnate, because God does not incarnate. And he's not the begotten Son of God, because begetting is an animal act. It belongs to the lower animal functions of sex, and we are not to attribute such a quality to God. Now, this is the Muslim stand. If that goes against your grain, against your belief, now you have every right to ask, Mr. Didat, you see, Jesus is God. So what makes him God? He said he had no father. So every person must have a father. So I have to agree, yes. So Jesus must also have a father. So if you can't show a father, who is his father? I said, no, he has no father. He said, no, his father is God. What have you to say now? So he is the begotten Son of God. He's God's only son. Talk like that. So what have you to say? We believe in the Holy Trinity. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You know, says, this is what our book says now. Do you accept the Trinity? Talk like that. The first questioner, he did a beautiful job. He said, look now, we believe about Christ. Resurrection. So I said, look, if there's no death, there's no resurrection. Talk like that. Look, this is the question. They said, now you want me to justify? Even now, you want me to justify? I said, look, I'll show you from your own book that you read something and you misunderstand the thing that you're reading. Let's put it to the audience. Let I put it to you. But now you, I says, you're crying now like a woman, you know, bashful maiden. He said, now look, you attack. What attack? What did I say disparaging about Jesus? You say that he called his mother woman in your book. I said, my book says, he says, وَبَرَّمْ بِوَالِدَتِي. He says, made me kind to my mother. وَجَعَلَنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا. And he's not made me, وَلَمْ أَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا. And not, you know, aggressive or abusing. Look, this is, the Quran is defending Jesus, that he never did any things that you are attributing to him, that he called the learned men of Israel, he's the elders of his people, you generation of vipers, you whited sepulchres, you wicked and adulterous generation, you snakes, you fools. Look, this is your record. My book says, no, he never did anything like that. Is that an attack? If that is an attack, then brother, you know, I apologize. By God, you know, I'm ashamed of myself. If this is an attack, The Quran says that he didn't do that. He respected his mother. That's an attack. Is that an attack? That he didn't abuse the people. Is that an attack? No, you must tell me, what is the attack? What is the attack? What did I say abusive about Jesus? I say he's one of the mightiest messengers of God. We love him, we respect him, we revere him. And we say follow him. Follow him. Because if you followed him, you'll be a Muslim. You're not following him. However, the opportunity to the questioners, please.